I present a response from the Minister for the Environment, Mr Hunt, to a resolution of the Senate of the 4th of March 2014 concerning the shark cull in Western Australia. Senator Seawood.
Thank you, Madam Acting Deputy President. I seek leave to take note of the response by Minister Hunt to the resolution of the 4th of March on the shark cull.
Is leave granted? Leave is granted.
Thank you. The Minister's response, I must say, I'm not surprised, although of course I am disappointed that the Minister has yet again failed to comply with the or to enact the intent of the motion the Senate passed on the 4th of March about the West Australian shark cull. He makes two points, or three points actually, in his letter. One is that he doesn't have to look at the impact of the shark cull on the Mako sharks that have been taken during the cull, of which we're aware there's two, there's possibly more, but there hasn't been a report for around 2 weeks in the number of sharks that have been taken, because he says that it's a migratory species and therefore he has to pay attention to Commonwealth waters. That's of course as if Mako sharks aren't going to be affected that an impact in state waters isn't therefore going to impact on sharks in Commonwealth waters. It's extremely disappointing that he doesn't seem to be concerned that this indiscriminate shark cull is impacting on a migratory species. Secondly, the minister says that he decided in the national interest to temporarily exempt the West Australian shark cull from the provisions of the Environmental Protection and Biodiversity Conservation Act. Now we're talking about the fact that 104, as of 2 weeks ago, 104 tiger sharks sharks had been caught, 101 of which are tiger sharks, 30 of which had been destroyed, and about another 10 had died on the hooks, and others have been released, although a lot of evidence, because these aren't being monitored by the government, there's a lot of anecdotal evidence to suggest that these sharks are not surviving the release, and in fact there's another shark today that was released, and there's footage available and photos available that show that shark lying on the bottom of the ocean in not looking very healthy, which is again further evidence that these sharks are being significantly harmed. So I don't think in any way, shape or form neither the West Australian government or the federal government can claim that the environmental impact of this shark cull, these drum lines, are they cannot claim that they're minimising environmental harm. One of the problems here is that the federal government granted an exemption, which they're now failing to monitor. They didn't require any independent monitoring or observation. They said that in a letter that I have received, in fact today, from the minister, separately in response to a letter I wrote to him, he said that they are using the hooks they said they were going to use. Well, now those hooks are causing environmental damage, so why aren't they then picking that issue up? But they have washed their hands of this issue because they have granted an exemption. And of course that exemption in itself is a misuse of section 158 of the Environmental Protection and Biodiversity Conservation Act, where provision is used for granting exemptions in the national interest. And we're talking about the national interest, we're talking about emergencies such as bushfires, floods, pipistrelle bat, when they had to put in place emergency provisions to look after the pipistrelle bat to save it from extinction, which unfortunately they put in place too late because they didn't save it from extinction. But to get back to the issue around it being misused to exempt the drumline provisions, that is a misuse of those provisions, which is why I tabled today a motion to introduce a private senator's bill, Save Our Sharks Bill of 2014, that would stop the use of this exemption clause, section 158, to allow drumlines to be put in place, because it is a misuse of that provision. It was never intended for this sort of action. It was convenient for this government to aid and abet Premier Barnett's knee-jerk PR exercise to make it look as if they're doing something about sharks, when in effect it's causing a great deal of damage. It isn't improving safety of ocean users in Western Australia. But of course the idea was to aid and abet the West Australian government to put in place the drum lines. This bill will stop those that abuse of the exemptions provision of the Act. And not only will it be effective from the 17th of March, which would mean the drum lines would have to come out straight away, it would also stop the West Australian government from going ahead and putting more drum lines in Western Australia after the April the 30th. Because both in the letter that I have received from Minister Hunt, Minister Hunt says at the end, the West Australian government has advised that they propose to establish an ongoing shark mitigation program. In other words, the drumline program will be extended from the 30th of April. Now, the Minister for the Environment, Mr Hunt, has said, well, it's okay. The West Australian government, I've told the West Australian government that the rollout of any extension of the program beyond the 30th of April will require a full assessment under the National Environmental Law. It's a pity you didn't do that previously, but there is absolutely no doubt in my mind that the West Australian government will try and seek another extension to enable them to roll out the drum lines while the assessment process is being undertaken. It is quite clear that will be the aim, or that will be their intention. The bill that I intend will read in tomorrow will stop that occurring. It will stop the West Australian government from being able to roll out those drum lines, because they will not be able to seek an extension from the Federal Minister for the Environment in order for them to facilitate the rollout of those drum lines. Of course, we know that this is a knee-jerk reaction from the West Australian government. Because great whites aren't prevalent off the West Australian coast at this time of the year, we know it's through September through to December, which is why it's so important that we don't allow the West Australian government to continue to roll out the drum lines, because even more sharks will be taken during that time. It is essential that the federal government stops this program, stops this indiscriminate cull of West Australian sharks, and starts looking at measures that really will help with the issues around safety, will involve discussions with the community, and put in place measures that genuinely work. In Western Australia yesterday, we saw another example of the community's opposition to the shark cull when we gathered at Leighton Beach, just near Fremantle, in fact, to form a human shark, so that we could again send a clear message to both the West Australian government and the federal government that this shark cull is indiscriminate, it has environmental impacts, that West Australians love the marine environment, they don't want this indiscriminate program that culls sharks, and they want a more thought-out approach, rather than Premier Barnett making it just look as if he is doing something, making it look as if he cares, when in effect, if he really cared, he wouldn't be going ahead with these drum lines just to be seen to be doing something. He would be investing those resources in better research, better alternatives, looking what works overseas, for example, the Brazilian exercise, where they do in fact have drum lines, but they're 3 kilometres offshore, much further offshore, and they use hooks that don't damage the sharks. The sharks are released and continue on their way. There's also a shark spotters program that works in South Africa that has proved to be very successful. While this exemption, the bill would remove this exemption, the minister has said he will carry out an environmental assessment program. In fact, he should be assessing drum lines around Australia, because they consistently use Queensland as an example of a program that works, when in effect I have articulated to this chamber on several occasions now how that doesn't work. We need to be using our Environmental Protection and Biodiversity Conservation Act to protect sharks. That's what that Act is for. It's got the words protect biodiversity in it. That's what that Act should be used for, not misusing sections of it, for example, section 158, to justify, to exempt a program that kills and maims sharks. It is having an unacceptable environmental impact. It should stop. We've got a bill to make it stop.
Thank you, Senator Seward. The question before the Senate is that the Senate takes note of the response to Senate resolution on shark coal. All those in favour say aye. Aye. Against, no. The ayes have